Welcome to SAP HXM Mornings. I'm Sven Ringling, SAP HXM Advisor at Orbis People in Germany. Today, I'd like to discuss SAP HCM for S/4HANA with you, short H4S4. Today, I want to discuss a little bit more what it is and especially what a good transition roadmap or schedule could look like. Let's start with the current solution. So this is relevant for you if you are using the on-premise SAP ERP HCM solution today. And what we know is that the standard maintenance of this solution is going up until 2027. And then there's an extended maintenance currently scheduled to end in 2030. So at some point in this timeline, you will need to do something about it. One obvious solution would be to leave the on-premise world and move it all to the cloud, to the SAP SuccessFactors HXM suite. But there are always reasons why this might not be possible or only be possible partially. So this is why SAP is now offering a new option, kind of a stopgap, the H4S4 solution. And it will become available in September 2022. And the maintenance guarantee of H4S4 is tied tightly to the general S/4HANA ERP maintenance guarantee, which currently goes up to 2040, but you can expect this to extend. So what would be a good time for you to actually move to the H4S4 solution? Obviously, we'd like to be earlier than that point, so we don't get into the more expensive and possibly troublesome maintenance. But maybe we also don't want to do it right in September 2022, because there's no need to be the first person to do something. So it's good to see how others deal with it and wait until some experience builds up in the market. So there's probably a time here that is the ideal window to plan for this transition and plan in consideration of all your other business priorities and resource availability. Anything earlier than that falls into the label of courageous. And anything behind here, well, it could also be courageous, because if there's any delay, you might actually blow the deadline. It's definitely expensive. And you might also start losing people because they see you like being the last person to go into any kind of new technology. Even though that might happen anyway, if you stay here and you're not actually moving anywhere into a modern cloud solution. In any case, before you do the actual transition, there needs to be a proper planning and preparation phase, right? So that doesn't have to wait until then. You can start today with your prep and plan phase. Doesn't have to be high intensity, but I recommend, if you haven't done so yet, start to get yourself the right information. And most notably, look into the plans that your organization is having regarding the transition of the whole S/4HANA business suite. Because that could also be a relevant trigger. Say, if your financial and logistics system make the cut over here, and this also falls into what we say the optimal window, not too courageous and not too expensive, then that could be a great candidate also for your transition in HCM, so you don't have to build any interim solution. If for any reason your finance colleagues will make the S4 transition before you can make this move, maybe they have done it already, then there are interim solutions in place with so-called compatibility packs. But if you can skip that step, that obviously saves you a little bit of effort. So look into this and align with your colleagues here. What we see often, that as soon as people in HR talk to their finance colleagues, they panic, because the transition from the traditional SAP ERP business suite to the S/4HANA is quite a big endeavor, because there's a big change in what the solution actually does. This change doesn't happen here. It's quite easy actually to move from your ERP HCM solution to H4S4. Why is it? Well, because there's no innovation. It's basically a one-to-one on a new platform. So, yeah, you don't pay a lot in terms of time and effort, but you don't get anything either, except that you basically can be doing what you have been doing all the time. So this is not about innovation. This is about preservation. Well, with some restrictions, there's not going to be any e-recruiting. The learning solution comes with restrictions, or the Java parts will probably go away. Obviously, in this transition, you also need to look at the integration with the new ERP suite, because I said there's a lot of change going on here. So you will have to look at all the integration, especially anything that's not standard. And then, well, this solution isn't even available yet. So we don't know what we don't know, but it will certainly be a good idea that after this switch, you actually do proper testing end to end. Therefore, as you have to invest some time here, even if it's quite an easy switch, it's definitely a good idea in this preparation phase to check what you actually need to move over, what you need to test, and what you can completely ignore because nobody has been using it for a couple of years. And also rethink your whole HRIT strategy. Maybe you get to the point that it does actually make sense to move some of that to SuccessFactors in the cloud, or maybe even go full cloud if this is late enough to have the new next generation cloud payroll from SAP available. So this just kind of a little wake up call, really. The message here is get information, plan, align with your finance and logistics colleagues in IT, and use this opportunity to review your whole HXM IT solution strategy, because it might be the best idea to not go for preservation, but go for innovation, at least in some process, and therefore move to SAP SuccessFactors at that point, or when we are talking about travel expense management, to SAP Concur. But the important point is start planning early. Thanks a lot for listening. I wish you a wonderful day and a wonderful planning experience. Goodbye.